We still have 1 minute. Let's start. Let me take the attendance first. So, so last time we did, the last thing we did was nucleus, which is the largest cell organelle. If we, in some books you will see that it's written largest cell organelle of the body. Arth, please mute yourself. Yeah, you're supposed to keep yourself mute till you have to ask any questions or you have to say anything. So last time we also discussed that nucleus, if we see in animal cells, it is centrally placed. Whereas in case of plant cells, most of the time in the mature plant cell, it shifts towards the periphery. And the reason being, because most of the space is occupied by the vacuole. About 90% space is occupied by the vacuole in the mature cells. In the young meristematic cells, you must be knowing vacuoles are not present. They are formed later on. Looking at the plant cell, we see it has a more specific shape because of the presence of cell wall, which is not there in the animal cells. This all you already know, so I would mostly concentrate on the things which you'll be not so familiar with, all the cell organelles. So before we discuss the details of the cell organelles, let's look into the cells, these eukaryotic cells, plant cell and animal cell. Arnav, Sahu, why are you late for this class? So if you look at the structures in the plant cell, other than the vacuole, of course, as you see, it is occupying a majority of the space. It has quite a big nucleus. And the next bigger organelle is the plastids. What are plastids? What do we know about plastids, Ananya?
Plastids, they give color to the cell. Like in plant cells, and they're only present in plant cells.
They are present in plant cells. Plastids, like, give an example, a type of plastid, say chloroplast, you are very well aware of.
Yes, chloroplast.
What is the function of chloroplast?
It contains chlorophyll, which is necessary for photosynthesis.
Good. So you see, plastids are only present in the plant cells, and we'll be doing the details of the plastids. But when we talk about chloroplast, you can see under even the light microscope, which are there in your laboratories, the compound microscope. So they are so big that you can see the structures. Even the mitochondria can be seen as rod-like structures, which are smaller than the plastids, but still they are visible, like dot-like structures in the compound microscope. You see the mitochondria? They can ask you to label these various parts. And sometimes we get confused in plastids and mitochondria. So if we look at the plastids, plastids are also double membrane structures, and mitochondria are also double membrane structures. But the mitochondria's inner membrane is highly folded. Whereas in case of chloroplast, the inner membrane is also straight. You see, it's smooth, but it has the bag-like structures, these stacks of grana inside, which gives it a different look. So with that, you should be able to recognize and be able to differentiate plastids or chloroplasts from mitochondria and should be able to correctly label. This is one problem I usually see in the children whenever they're. One, I told you they are much bigger. Plastids are much bigger than mitochondria. When the two, you will draw the two, you will draw it proportionately as you see here. Secondly, its inner wall is highly folded, whereas the inner wall is not folded here. But it has in the center those folded structures inside these grana, which is made up of thylakoids. They have this pigment, green pigment in the case of chloroplast, which is called chlorophyll, and Ananya rightly said, told its function. Okay. Then, other than that, you see lysosomes are there, but they are not visible under the compound microscope. You can look at this. This is an animal cell. You see, the outermost layer is the plasma membrane. There's no cell wall. They have mitochondria. There are no plastids. Look at the structure of mitochondria. The inner membrane is highly folded. I will tell you why so. Then the lysosomes. And then, of course, whole of the animal cell and the plant cell have large number of another cell organelle, which is called endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum. Okay. What is the composition of plasma membrane, Arth? What is plasma membrane made of? We did in our last class. Ananya?
Ma'am, it's made of protein and I think lipids.
Very good. Yes, proteins and lipids. Okay. So, the nuclear membrane is also made up of proteins and lipids. And the endoplasmic reticulum is also having the same composition as plasma membrane. I see that other children have also joined. I want to take the attendance. Harshita is here. Punita, Arnav is there. Arth.
Yes, ma'am.
Mukul Mahajan, Muskan Pandey is here. Pratyush.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So we are discussing nothing much we have done. We are just looking at the cell organelles which are present in eukaryotic cells. Both plant cells and animal cells which you are drawing are eukaryotic cells. How can you say they are eukaryotic? What is the characteristic feature of eukaryotic cells? They have a well-defined nucleus. Nucleus with the nuclear membrane present. And last time we did the structure of nucleus also, which consists of nucleoplast. It has the chromatin material, which during this, just before the cell division, they condense to form rod-like chromosomes. What is the composition of chromosomes? Somebody? Arnav? Chromosomes are also made up of proteins. And what is the other component? That's the genetic material, DNA. DNA and proteins. Huh? So that nucleus, wherever you see this nucleus present, that's an eukaryotic cell. Because prokaryotic cells do not have a well-defined nucleus. Rather, they have a single circular chromosome,
Close track, please wait for some time.
Hello.
Please call somebody.
Ma'am, you are not visible. The screen is not visible.
What the hell is going on? शायद कभी हो सकूं मैं तुमको
Ma'am, kindly unmute yourself. You are muted, I think so.
Ma'am, unmute yourself.
Oh, yes. So, welcome back. I had some problem with the internet connection, so that is why for some time I couldn't take the class. Now, let me resume. Just showing my... Okay, are you able to see the screen?
No, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Huh?
No, ma'am.
Okay, now it's visible, huh?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Now it's visible.
Okay, I'll just put it on slideshow. Yeah, it's here. So we were talking about endoplasmic reticulum. And endoplasmic reticulum are of two types, rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. As the name suggests, smooth is because their surface is smooth. And in rough, there are these small dot-like structures, ribosomes present. Because of that, its surface looks rough. That is why the name rough endoplasmic reticulum. As I told you, they are like elongated tubes and sheets which are connected to each other. They are spread all over the cytoplasm, starting from the plasma membrane till the end of nucleus. So one of the functions you can say is transporting materials within the cytoplasm, and also from the cytoplasm to the nucleus, or the exchange of material between nucleoplasm and the cytoplasm. Okay, so this you can very easily remember and write one of the functions of endoplasmic reticulum. This you will find in both the plant cells also. It is present. See, it is scattered all around, blue colored structures. And mostly the rough endoplasmic reticulums are near the nucleus, and smooths are away, but not any hard and fast rule. You can draw, see, they are near and they are far off. Now, from the endoplasmic reticulum only, the next cell organelle is formed, and that is called Golgi complex. Rough endoplasmic reticulum form the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, and smooth endoplasmic reticulum form the Golgi complex. I will talk about the role of Golgi complex also. And it has a specific region near the nucleus in case of animal cells. In case of plant cells, Golgi complex is known as dictyosomes. See, it is written dictyosomes. Now, this is spread in the, it is not restricted to one region. It is spread in the whole of the plant cell. You see, so many places they have shown the dictyosomes. Whereas Golgi apparatus is always placed at one region here. Another very important feature which is there in the animal cells and not present in plant cells is the centrosome. Centrosome, with it has inside two rod-like structures which are called centrioles. So centrioles with centrosome is given in your books also, NCERT. So they ask you, usually they don't ask the details, but yes, whether it is there in the plant cell or not, and what is its role. So centrosome basically is important during the cell division because it forms the spindle fibers, which are very important or the process of cell division. When you'll do in higher classes, you'll understand. But at this time, you can just remember they are important for the cell division. Okay, I would like to. Okay, so this is basically majority of the cell organelles we have discussed in according to their position in the cell. Yeah, vacuoles.
Ma'am, what is peroxisome?
Okay, we are coming over to peroxisomes also. Yeah, so you look at the vacuoles here, they are very small vacuoles, whereas if you see in case of plant cell, the central vacuole, large vacuole is there. Peroxisomes are present both in the plant cells as well as in the animal cells, though it is not in your course, but these are the vesicles which contain certain enzymes. And these enzymes, according to the kind of enzymes they contain for the breakdown of certain molecules. So in general, these are the vesicles with certain
Ma'am, the screen is not visible.
चाय लगाने भैया
Mom, the screen is not visible.
Wait. There is some network issue again. Wait for some time. Hello students, there is some network issue. Wait for 2 minutes only.
Welcome back. I think there is some problem with the internet connection. Okay, so let's go into the detail of the various cell organelles now. Comparative study we have done. Cell wall is absent in animal cells but present in plant cells. Blastids are absent in animal cells but present in plant cells. Centrosomes with centrioles are present in animal cell but absent in plant cells. Large vacuoles are absent in plant cells but present in plant cells. Then carbohydrates are stored as glycogen in animals, whereas carbohydrates are stored as starch in case of plant cells. Then lysosomes are present in animal cells and they are few or usually absent in plant cells. Okay, so let's come over to the endoplasmic reticulum. There's a lot of text in your textbooks itself. The major things I'll be covering so that you have an understanding of the cell organelle. You have to understand the structure and the functions of endoplasmic reticulum in general and the function of smooth and rough endoplasmic reticulum. So as I told you that, you know, rough endoplasmic reticulum has formed from the nuclear membrane itself. So the composition of nuclear membrane and the endoplasmic reticulum is same. Then the composition of nuclear membrane is same as the composition of plasma membrane. So obviously the composition of all three is same, and this composition is lipids and proteins mainly. Now, as I told you, they are all tubes and sheets and interconnected with each other. You can see here, it's a three-dimensional structure. And on their surface, they're present ribosomes. Ribosomes are the membrane-less structures which are present both in prokaryotes as well as eukaryotes. And they are the sites for protein synthesis. Hence, the function of one of the important functions of rough endoplasmic reticulum is the synthesis of proteins. And the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, there are no ribosomes present, but they are very important in the synthesis of mainly the fats, lipids, steroids, cholesterols, etc. They're all types of lipids. So you can just remember as fats and lipids are synthesized here. And you know, lipids and proteins, they form the cell membrane. So the products of the rough endoplasmic reticulum, that is the protein and the lipids formed by the SCR, they both have the capability of regenerating or forming the plasma membrane. And this process is known as membrane biogenesis. This term is given in your text and you have to remember this term. So it is nothing. Membrane biogenesis is the process by which a new membrane, plasma membrane, can be formed with the help of the proteins and lipids synthesized by the ER. Okay. Now, as I told you, ER serves as channels for the transport of material. They are distributed within the cytoplasm and they help in the transport of material between the nucleoplasm and the cytoplasm and within the cytoplasm also. So mainly this is it. And I told you that Golgi apparatus is formed from the endoplasmic reticulum. This is the Golgi apparatus. Now, Golgi apparatus has these elongated sheet-like structures which are called cisternae. They are, you can say, similar diameter tube in the center, but at the edges, they have been widened. These kind of structures are called cisternae. There is this central space, which is called lumen here. They have two faces, one or rather poles of the Golgi apparatus. One is the cis face and another is the trans face. So in the cis face, the various components which have been synthesized in the endoplasmic reticulum, it comes here. And it forms the transport vesicles, as you see, incoming transport vesicles, which are supplying those materials inside the Golgi apparatus. Now, the role of the Golgi apparatus is to modify this material which reaches the Golgi apparatus, and then they repack, they pack it nicely, and then they send it to the place where it is being required. And when before this end, this is on the other pole of the Golgi apparatus, which is the transphase. Here, those vesicles which have been formed inside which the material is present could be various. These are called secretory vesicles, which are sent to the place where the material is required. So this is one of the major functions of Golgi apparatus. Other than that, Golgi apparatus also produces lysosomes. They also form complex sugar from the simple sugars in certain cases. So you need to remember this, and there are certain functions, all these functions given in your textbooks. You can just refer your book for that as well. Okay, other than lysosomes, yeah, in your book it is given lysosomes are synthesized, but they also synthesize cell wall and plasma membrane. If you can remember, it's fine, otherwise not so important. It produces vacuoles which contain cellular secretions, and it also acts as an area, as I told you, storage and packaging of various cell secretions. Next comes lysosomes in your book. It is also known as suicide bag of the cell. Before suicide bag, we discussed it is the waste disposal system of cell scavengers, because they have these digestive enzymes, or what is called hydrolytic enzymes, inside the lysosomes. And these digestive enzymes digest the worn out materials of foreign particles. When the cell stops functioning or is not able to function properly, the lysosomes, they burst and they engulf and digest the cell itself. That is why it is called suicide bags of the cell. Okay, so this is a single membrane. Yes.
Ma'am, suppose any virus or bacteria is entering in our cells. So does the lysosome perform to blast the cell or blast the virus or not?
It is basically in that particular one lysosome. If one lysosome bursts, it has a little amount of digestive enzymes, so it's sufficient for the viruses and bacteria to be killed. But when the whole cell is not able to perform, all the lysosomes present in the cell, they burst.
Okay.
Thus, they digest whole of the cell.
Okay.
Then you have another important cell organelle, which is mitochondria. The outer membrane you see is a smooth membrane, but it is highly porous. The inner membrane has a lot of infoldings. You can see these foldings. This is how it can be recognized. This is the recognizing feature also. These are called cristae. And it is on the cristae that the ATP is synthesized. ATP is the energy currency of the cells, because this is the high energy molecules. And they break down, they go to the region where they are required, and they break down there as ADP and inorganic phosphate. So the synthesis of these ATP takes place inside the mitochondria, and that is why mitochondria is known as powerhouse of the cell. And since it is the ATP which breaks and releases large amount of energy for the activity of the various cellular activities, biological activities which are taking place, and they require energy. So that is why they are called energy currency of the cell. Mitochondria is also said to be a semi-autonomous organelle. It is a very strange organelle, reason being that it contains its own ribosomes and the genetic material, that is DNA or RNA. They say these organelles must be sometimes back existing independently and later on became the part of cells. So they still consist of the ribosomes and the DNA. So because of those DNA and RNA, they can form some of the parts of their, they can rather regenerate themselves. They can form some parts of these organelles. And that is why they're known as semi-autonomous organelle. There's another organelle which is semi-autonomous organelle. Anybody knows?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Plastids. Plastids are also semi-autonomous organelles. Again, because inside the plastids, you will find ribosomes and DNA present. If these two, mitochondria and plastids, since they have ribosomes as well as the DNA material present, they are able to form certain proteins and certain parts. That is why they are known as semi-autonomous organelles. Okay. So coming over to the plastids, they are small colored bodies in the cytoplasm. they can be two types. One is green colored and other are non-green, some other colors. Oh, sorry, there are three types rather. One is green plastids, others are non-green. Among the non-green, one is the colored plastid and other is the colorless plastids. So they are chloroplast, chromoplast, and leucoplast. Leucoplasts are colorless. So chloroplast, you all know the structure here, the green color structure. This is the chloroplast, the inner of the chloroplast. If you see, there are lots of bag-like structures, elongated bag-like structures, which form a stack. It's like stack of coins, which are interconnected with each other through the lamellae. Here the photosynthesis takes place, and the photosynthesis light reaction takes place in this granum part, and the dark reaction takes place in the stroma part. Stroma is the matrix, the general space matrix, semi-fluid substance present here, that is the stroma. Then, other than that, chromoplast, so chloroplast contains chlorophyll. And Ananya rightly said that chlorophyll traps the sunlight and helps in the photosynthesis. Now there are colored plastids, chromoplast. Chromoplast contains pigments like carotenoids and xanthophylls. Carotenoids are orange red and xanthophylls are yellowish colored, and they impart colors to various fruits and flowers. And if they're imparting color to flowers, it is for attracting the insects for pollination. And the fruits which are colorful are to attract the animals and of course other insects and all for their seed dispersal. So that's the function you can write for chromoplast. Leucoplasts are of three types: amyloplast, elaioplast, and proteinoplast. So as the name suggests, proteinoplast is they store proteins. Elaioplast store fats and lipids, and amyloplast stores the starch. So if you can remember amyloplast, elaioplast, proteinoplast, fine. Otherwise, I mean, not very frequently asked. Mainly you should remember chromoplast, chloroplast, and leucoplast. Any doubt here? Okay. So coming over the last cell organelle, which is the vacuoles. They are full of cell sap. They provide rigidity and turgidity of the turgidity to the cell. As the water which enters the cell, it goes into the vacuole and the vacuole enlarges. So there is this turgor pressure increases inside the cell, which provides it the turgidity. Vacuoles, as we have talked about already, they are large in plant cells and small in animal cells. The outermost layer, they are single-celled, the single membrane structures, and their membrane is known as stenoplast. The stenoplast also has the same composition as the plasma membrane. What is the composition of plasma membrane? Ananya?
Yes, ma'am. Can you
what is the question? Yeah. What is the composition of plasma membrane?
It's lipids and proteins.
Yes. So stenoplast is also lipids and proteins, single membrane. Okay, let us first do the comparison between the plant cell and the animal cell. So cell membrane is present in plant cells. What about in animal cells?
And they are absent. No.
Who said?
No, no, it is present only.
Present, na? Because cell, the basic three components of cell includes plasma cell membrane or plasma membrane. Tell me the three parts of the cell, of any cell, main basic parts.
Ma'am, nucleus, cytoplasm, and cell membrane.
Very good. Okay. What about cell wall in plant cells?
Ma'am, it is present.
Yeah, and that is absent in animal cell. What about nucleus?
Ma'am, present in both of them.
Right. And nuclear membrane? It's present in both of them?
Yes.
Because they are eukaryotic cells. We are talking about eukaryotic. Prokaryotic cells like bacteria, blue-green algae, mycoplasma, they lack nucleus. So they lack nucleus, they lack nuclear membrane. Okay. Then cytoplasm?
Present in both.
Right. Plastids?
Present in plant and absent in animals.
Very good. And vacuoles? This mentioned. Smaller in size and... this is... Do you think this is correctly written?
No, ma'am. That is vice versa. Means it's in plant, it will be large, and in animal, it will be small.
Yes, so that you can correct. What about centriole with centrosome?
Ma'am, absent in plant cells and present in animal cells.
Yes, very good. In animal cells, they are present, yes. So that's it. Okay, let's do this exercise first. Which cell organelles are called suicidal bags of the cell?
Lysosomes.
Powerhouse of the cell?
Mitochondria.
Energy currency of the cell?
Mitochondria.
ATP full form?
It's adenosine triphosphate.
Very good. Kitchen of the cell?
Plastid.
Yeah, which plastid?
Chloroplast.
Right. DNA full form?
Deoxyribonucleic acid.
Nucleic acid, yes. Chromosomes are composed of?
Repeat the question.
Chromosomes are composed of which part? They are made up of?
Proteins and?
Yes.
DNA.
Very good. And nuclear membrane is made up of? Same as plasma membrane.
Proteins and lipids.
Lipids and protein.
Absolutely. Site of protein synthesis?
Protein synthesis. No idea, ma'am.
Ribosomes. That is why rough endoplasmic reticulum is also produces protein, because it is produced in the ribosomes. Okay, so before we talk about these questions in NCERT, and do you have your NCERT, no? So read this questions given on page number 63. Somebody? Ananya?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, read this question one, which is given on page number 63.
The one on the screen?
Not on the screen, it's on the NCERT.
Yeah, okay. It's fill in the gaps in the following table illustrating different differences between prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells.
Okay, this we will not do because we haven't done prokaryotic in detail. Okay, read the questions on page number 65.
Can you name the two organelles we have studied that contain their own genetic material? That's the first.
Yeah, tell me the answer.
Mitochondria and plastids.
Very good. And that is why they are also known as?
What was that?
Semi-autonomous.
Semi-autonomous.
Absolutely. Yes. And then next. Next question.
If the organism of the cell is destroyed due to some physical or chemical influence, what will happen?
See, organization of a cell is destroyed. So a cell is properly organized and it maintains its homeostasis. Homeostasis is maintaining the internal chemical environment. So if the organization is destroyed, then they won't be able to maintain homeostasis, like nutrition, will not be able to exist. Then next question.
It's why are lysosomes known as suicide bags?
Tell me.
Ma'am, because they are, when any bacteria or virus interact or just enter in the cell, so they they just blast themselves and englobe the virus, which reduce or stop the virus to spread in other cells.
So see, that is there. So that is why they are cell scavengers. But suicidal means you kill yourself. So that is your killing when the cell is being destroyed, when the cell is not functioning properly, all the lysosomes burst and they digest their own cell, whole of the cell components. That is why it is a suicidal act. Okay. That you will mention. Where are proteins synthesized inside the cell?
In the ribosomes.
Absolutely. So let's now go back before us talk about this, because before we forget, this topic is important. Prokaryotes. I'm just looking for the prokaryotic bacterial structure. Is there the bacteria? Prokaryotic. I will just show you on the. What do you know about prokaryotic cell?
They have nuclear membrane. I mean, they don't have nuclear membrane.
Yes.
And eukaryotic cells have nuclear membrane. They have nuclear membrane.
Yes. And?
And the cell organelles, they have a boundary in eukaryotic cells, but then they don't in prokaryotic cells.
Okay, just one second.
Mom, screen is not visible.
Screen is not visible. I'll just run. Okay, are you able to see this now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So this is one of the structure of a bacteria. If you look at the structure of a bacteria, there's certain important things we will discuss. Okay, so this is having other parts present. It has a plasma membrane, it has cytoplasm, but in the center there is this one single circular DNA present. Only one DNA is present. There is no concept of nucleus at all. No well-organized structure nucleus present. No nuclear membrane is there. Only one single DNA. And the region in which it is there in the cytoplasm, this region is known as nucleoid. They ask you what is nucleoid. Other than the central chromosome, these may have one or two small circular DNAs in the sides also, and they are known as plasmid DNAs. Okay. Other than that, they have double membrane. Then outer to the plasma membrane, they have the cell wall, but this cell is made up of cellulose, whereas these prokaryotic cells, cell wall is made up of a material which is known as peptidoglycan. Then, are you able to hear me?
Yes, ma'am, but your voice is lagging.
There is some disturbance in the connection I saw. Okay, and outside the cell wall, there is another membrane present you know, that is that is that could be rigid or it could be slimy. This is the outermost layer which forms. See, there is written capsule. It may form a slimy layer or it may form a hard capsule. So that is glycocalyx, made up of glycocalyx. So this is a slightly different structure than your eukaryotic membrane. Then they usually have cilia present, one to three flagella, the long whip-like structure which helps them in the movement, locomotion. Other than that, these are called pili. Hello, are you able to hear me?
Yes ma'am.
Yeah, so they have small pili present, and these a number of hair like structures on the body. They help to attach them to the some support. It could be a rock or it could be the host. If it is a host, then any of the part of the host, they attach themselves with the help of these pili. So this is the structure of prokaryotic cell. Now we can do this. This is very important. 63 page number you all take out. There is this difference between prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. So we will fast do these 4 points and then we are finished with this chapter. Look at the size. It's very small. Prokaryotic cells are small as 1 to 10 micrometers. Whereas size of the eukaryotic cells is 5 to 100 micrometers. Now, prokaryotic cell, the nuclear region is known as, what is the nuclear region known as? Nucleoid. Whereas in eukaryotes, it is well-defined and it is surrounded by nuclear membrane. Now, prokaryotes are single chromosome and they have more than one chromosome. What is the number of chromosomes in human cell?
I am not sure, ma'am. 22.
23 pairs, 46 chromosomes. So they are present in pairs in humans, normal cells, and in the gametes they also when they pairs 23, and when the cell is single set of 23 sperm cells. Like sperms and ova, then it is called haploid cell, single set of chromosomes. The last point, membrane-bound cell organelles are absent and membrane-bound cell organelles are present. So this completes our prokaryotic cells as well. So you can go through the exercise questions. I think we have between plant cells and animals we have done. Then compare, the second question is compare between prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. We have done. What would happen if plasma membrane ruptures or breaks down? So this will disrupt the cell organization, and the answer will be same as we had done for the earlier one, that if the organization of the cell is destroyed, what will happen? There will be homeostasis, so the basic function cell will not be able to perform, and hence the cell will die. Then what would happen to the life of a cell if there is no Golgi apparatus? So we all know this is so important for modifying, packing and sending the material to various cells. So any part of the well-organized structure, anything is not working properly, the cell will not work properly, and hence it can die. It ceases to exist. Which organelle is known as powerhouse of the cell and why?
Mitochondria, because it stores the power and the protein which will fulfill the requirement of the cell.
Because they synthesize ATP. The ATPs are synthesized inside the mitochondria, and ATPs are called the energy currency of the cell. They break down and release energy wherever required. Where do the lipids and proteins constituting cell membrane get synthesized? Lipids in the SCR and proteins in the RER. How does an amoeba obtain its food? by the what is the process called? Endocytosis. Endocytosis, that engulfs the food material with the help of their by extending the pseudopodias, and then they form food vacuole and then they obtain the food. What is osmosis?
The process of going out the material.
The movement of water from its higher concentration to its lower concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. Now see this one. Carry out the following osmosis experiment. They have taken 4 peeled potato halves, then scooped the center of it, and then these potatoes made, one is boiled potato. So they have kept, made from, okay, one of the cups is boiled potato and then each is containing water. Now keep cup A empty, B they have put sugar, and C they have put salt, and D they have put sugar in the boiled cup. Keep them for 2 hours and then observe what happens. So what will happen? Only in case of cup B and C, the water will rise. Water will get inside the hollow portion, but not in the others. So this rise of water is because of osmosis. Water enters because there is a concentrated solution inside the cell scoop. And the last one, the water doesn't enter because the dead cells, the dead plasma membrane cannot perform osmosis. So it is because of the osmosis, and the last case it will not be able to perform the osmosis. So with that we finish this. In next class we can start with the tissues. And know these questions we have discussed. Okay, so thank you. And see you in the next class.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.